Everyone, happy Sunday. So today I'm coming back to you. I started some motivational videos back like in February and then I stopped. So I kind of wanted to restart that again and I guess share with you a little bit about what's been going on with me. So I suffered a few setbacks recently, about 2-3 weeks ago. I suffered some setbacks and it got me thinking about how I can reshape my failures and my challenges and look at them from a positive perspective. And so today I wanted to share with you just some of the things that I learned within the last few weeks, and hopefully they'll be helpful to you, especially because this is a new month, it is a new day, and it's definitely a new quarter. So as we embark on going into the next quarter and going on through the year, we want to be able to make good choices and you know, have success in everything that we choose to do. So one of the things that stood out to me was what Oprah said, or, you know, she said this a few different times, but she said that there's no such thing as a failure, only opportunities to grow. And I will say, admittedly, I had forgotten, you know, that I had forgotten that premise or that thought, that concept, and it really started to affect me a little bit because I was getting bogged down by the failures or the challenges and the obstacles that I was facing on my day-to-day, and it really affected my mood, so to speak. But anyway, so today, just a quick little video to help you get started through your week and your month and your quarter as we continue down the year. So one of the things I looked at was I learned that rather than looking at each slip up or setback as failure, I needed to know that experiences are opportunities to learn. They're an opportunity to customize and adjust as well, and ultimately to be able to see long-term success. So I just kind of wanted to share that with you. And so how do we do that? We would want to ask ourselves four questions. The first question is, why did it happen? So you had a failure or you had a setback or a challenge. Why did it happen? Can you pinpoint why? And this can be attributed to maybe if you are like trying to lose weight or get your health together and you slipped up and ate something you shouldn't eat, or, you know, drank alcohol even though you said that you weren't going to drink it, or you broke your Lent fast and you said you were going to do no coffee, no sugar, but then you drank your coffee and you ate your sugar. Why did it happen? By pinpointing that, you are able to put in different things in place to ensure that it doesn't happen again. Okay, and then the next question is, what can I learn from this? And this is what Oprah talks about. You know, it's an opportunity to learn and to grow versus a failure. And the way that you look at something, and the way that you your mindset about that situation is what determines whether you learn from it or not. So that question is so important. You know, what can I learn from this? And then the next question is, how can I improve or prevent this next time? So this is what I was talking about as far as, how do I make sure that I don't drink that coffee? Maybe I can drink tea instead, or, you know, I can drink kombucha tea. You know, this is going back to your weight loss, but just in general, in life period, you know, what can you do to improve the next, so that in the next situation, you don't find yourself making that same mistake or, you know, facing that same obstacle. And then lastly, which is, I feel, is the most important one, and it's one that you should ask yourself every day, especially if you're one of those people that likes to plan out your day. You know, you plan out your week, you plan out your month, you know, you kind of want to take a stock and do a checklist and to see, did I do everything that I said that I was going to do? And then, you know, ask yourself, how did I do 1% better than I did yesterday? And this question is so powerful because when you focus on what you did better, it helps you celebrate all your accomplishments, no matter how small they are. If your accomplishment was, I'm not gonna do sugar today, and you went until noon and you didn't do any sugar, and then you had sugar at 1 o'clock, 1 p.m., you still had a success. You were able to go from 8 to 12 without eating sugar. And so when you focus on the things that you do, your wins, your W's, you know, as it were, through the day, through the week, you're able to maintain those wins, and then eventually you're able to have bigger wins, you know, and then it trains your brain to consistently seek out winning. And that's where we want to be ultimately, right? So I just hope that this is very helpful, you know, as you go through your day and you go through your week and you go through your month and your quarter, to be able to put these things in place so that you're able to continue to fight, to do better, to see better and be able to have long-term success. So that is all for today. I wish you a great and happy Sunday and a great week ahead, a great month ahead. And I wish you all the success and a healthy and vibrant life. Okay, so live your best life. And thank you all that joined today. Until next time. Bye-bye.